Welcome to raigurukul.com. In this video, we'll discuss about how to utilize OpenAI or ChatGPT in software testing process. So if you heard about this tool, ChatGPT, a revolutionary AI-based product, where by using this, probably we can make our life easy in software testing. So I will guide you how we can utilize this tool for our software testing requirement. If you want to learn software testing in detail, please watch my software testing playlist. And for making our life in software testing, please watch complete video. Now, coming down to the ChatGPT AI based tool. Let's say we were working on any product and we want some detail about that product, maybe some business scenarios or business related test cases, and probably we can write the test case in detail. Now, coming down to some other requirement, let's say we want to build a test case, then we can use ChatGPT. Then if you want to draft a scenario, or maybe I can see test scenario, then also we can use ChatGPT. Other than that, if you want to prepare test plan or test strategy, ChatGPT also help us to do so. After that, which all components we can include in different documentations, that is also we can ask with ChatGPT. If we want to understand the complete process of defect reporting or maybe some other detail, by using that we can build or use ChatGPT in software testing process. So let's say we want to write the test cases on WhatsApp. So here we'll majorly focus on any one applications. If you don't want to go ahead with any major or functional applications, then probably we can target some small application as well. So let's take an example of Notepad. So Notepad is well used applications in day-to-day life. So let's understand how we can build the test cases on Notepad. So here, let's say I want to create a test cases. So here I want just write down all test cases on Notepad. Let's see, I want to write the test cases on WhatsApp. So if you can see here we have started with the WhatsApp applications. So this will verify the user is able to register successfully with a valid phone number and verification code. Then test cases for login, verify that user is able to log in successfully with the correct credentials. In chat messaging, then test cases of voice calling, video calling, media sharing, group messaging, notifications, message and calls. Now, if I want to just write down the negative test cases of video calling. So here, negative test cases of video calling feature in WhatsApp. So now this will start writing the negative test cases of video calling feature in WhatsApp. This is initiating the video call with contact who is not currently online or available to receive a call, which is a negative test cases. For thinking these test cases, writing these test cases will consume a lot of time. But ChatGPT is helping us to draft all the test cases by own. So maybe sometimes we'll not get everything, but 60 to 70% of the time we'll have all the test cases are readily available. We don't have to invest much time on writing these test cases. Now, let's say I want just high priority test cases on WhatsApp. So here, least high priority test cases on WhatsApp. So first our primary task is registrations, where we can the user is registered or not, then login, test cases on chat messaging, test cases on voice calling. So these all features, or by using these features we have to verify it. So these are the high priority test cases. So this is all coming together for the test cases. Let's say we want to write or list all the test cases for the login page. So all write all the test cases for login page. So you can see we are getting all the test cases for the login page, which comprises of positive as well as negative test cases. So which is very much interesting things. Probably we might miss some of the test cases so that we can make the changes accordingly. We cannot directly rely with this type of tool or this type of AI based tool 100%, but 60 to 70% or 80% of time we can use this type of tool to save our time as well as our resources. This is also helping us to minimize our effort on writing these test cases. Now let's say I want to draft test scenarios. So here, for drafting a test scenario, probably we can again use some other applications. I'm not sure about WhatsApp link. Probably we can use some other applications like Facebook. So here, list all the test scenario of Facebook. So Facebook is again coming down to the registration page, then login, then we have to cover news feed, then messaging. So these all features, based on the features, it will draft the scenarios when we want in detail format. So here, more or friend request scenarios and test cases. Probably we can add detailed test scenarios on friend request. So based on the functionality, it will start writing these test cases, and even we have page creations. There are a lot many features are there. So let me stop it here. Now after that, let's say I want to generate all test scenario on friend request. So you can see all the test scenarios will be generated automatically, and here we will get all the test scenarios. We can copy and paste, and based on then we can modify it. Now this is coming down to the test scenario. If I want to write the test plan and I was not aware of the what all components will included in test plan, then probably we can use ChatGPT or AI based tool to generate a test plan roadmap. So here, which all components we will use while writing test plan. So this will give us idea which all factors will be included in test plan and test strategy so that we can build a test plan and test strategy. Let's say I want to build a test plan for WhatsApp applications. So create test plan for WhatsApp. Here, I will stop this because it will take time to generate all those components, which contains introduction, test strategy, test objective, test scope, test environment, test schedule, test cases, test data, test execution, risk and issues, assumptions and dependency, and sign off. Finally, now if I want to create a test plan for WhatsApp, then probably I will just hit enter. So now you can see it started executing. So again, I'm repeating again, we cannot get each and everything is generated by using ChatGPT, but ChatGPT is making our life easy to generate this type of report, to write down the test cases or maybe test scenarios. So this is how it is helping a testing team make their life easy using ChatGPT. Now next is We have discussed all those four pointers. So if I want to write down the defects or the created defect, so if I want to search for any particular tool like Jira, by the way, if you want to learn Jira, please watch my Jira playlist. And we don't know what is the procedure, which all components will include it or DTL will include it. So we can search it through this. So best practices to add best DTL to add steps to reproduce while defect reporting. Even if you don't know how to reach the defect in any particular tool, that is also we can search it from there. Any informations which we are looking for, we can search it, and this tool will guide us how we can get it. So here, which all details will include it, steps to reproduce, expected result, actual result, environment details. So these are, if we are writing an email, so probably we have to write down in environment details or frequency and impact. Other than that, we are also attaching documents or recording or supporting documents. But if we are using any particular tool, then probably we will get a fields to add it. So this is how we can write down our defects using, or which all fields will be required for writing a defect. Now, if we have any defects name, then probably we can search the defects with the defects name as well. So this is how ChatGPT is helping a software tester to make their life easy while testing process. So that's all from this video. Hope you enjoyed the content. If think so, this will be useful. Don't forget to share within your circle. Thank you for watching.